Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics. In this video, we learn 1's complement and 2's complement representation of the binary numbers. These two methods are most commonly used in digital circuit. We can broadly classify binary numbers into two categories, unsigned binary numbers and signed binary numbers. The unsigned binary numbers are only positive numbers without any sign convention. On the other hand, by using the signed binary numbers, we can represent both positive and negative binary numbers. There are three different types to represent the signed binary numbers. First one, sign magnitude form. Second one, 1's complement form. Third one, 2's complement form. We will discuss these binary number representations one by one. First of all, let's briefly discuss about unsigned binary numbers. By using unsigned binary numbers, we can only represent positive numbers. So here, this 0, 1, 1, 0, 1 represent decimal value of plus 13 in 5 bit. Here this 2 to the power of 0 to 2 to the power of 4 are the weight of each bit. If you use n bits to represent a decimal number in binary form, then the range of numbers that we can represent are 0 to 2 to the power of n minus 1. For example, using 5 bits, we can represent decimal numbers from 0 to 2 to the power of 5 minus 1. Here 2 to the power of 5 means 32. So 2 to the power of 5 minus 1 equals to 31. Hence, we can represent numbers from 0 to 31. On the other hand, by using signed binary numbers, we can represent both positive and negative numbers. Here, the MSB or most significant bit is a sign bit. For example, in a 5-bit signed binary number 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, this MSB bit 0 is the sign bit and the remaining bits represents the magnitude. So this binary number 0, 1, 1, 0, 1 represents plus 13 in decimal format. Here, depending on the value of the sign bit, that is 0 or 1 of the MSB bit, we can decide whether the number is positive or negative. So if we have n bit signed binary number, then the MSB bit is a sign bit and the remaining n minus 1 bits represents the magnitude of that number. For example, a 5-bit signed binary number, 5 minus 1 bits, that is 4 bits, represents magnitude and the MSB bit represents its sign. As we have discussed before, there are 3 different methods to represent these signed binary numbers. We will discuss them one by one. First one, sign magnitude form. In sign magnitude form, if the sign bit or MSB bit is equals to 0, then it represents positive number. On the other hand, if the MSB is equals to 1, then it represents negative number. For example, if you want to represent plus 27 in the 8-bit sign magnitude form, then its magnitude is represented in true binary form, that is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Here the MSB must be 0. This shows the number have positive sign and rest of the bits are its magnitude. On the other hand, for minus 27 in 8-bit sign magnitude form will be represented as 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Here we can see that MSB bit is 1. It shows the number is negative and rest of the bits are its magnitude. Here we can clearly notice between these two numbers, plus 27 and minus 27, only the sign bit is changed, but the rest of the magnitude bits are same. This is how we can represent any number in this signed magnitude form. But if you want to represent 0 in 8 bits, we will write it as 8 zeros. Here MSB or sign bit is 0. So this 0 is positive 0. If we put 1 in MSB instead of 0, then it becomes minus 0 represented in 8-bit form. This is a special case of representing 0. There are two different representations of 0 in sign magnitude form. Now let's see the range of numbers that can be represented using sign magnitude form. For example, in this 4-bit binary number, MSB is the sign bit and rest of the 3 bits represents its magnitude or value bits. So the positive numbers that can be represented using 3 bits are plus 0 to plus 7. That can be expressed as plus 0 to 2 to the power of n minus 1 minus 1. Here our n equals to 4 bits. On the other hand, the negative numbers that can be represented using these 3 value bits are minus 0 to minus 7. That can be expressed as minus 0 to 2 to the power of n minus 1 minus 1. Here the total range for this 4 bit binary number is from plus 7 to minus 7. This total range can be expressed as plus 2 to the power of n minus 1 minus 1 to minus 2 to the power of n minus 1 minus 1. Here in this table, we can see the 4 bit sign magnitude form representation. There are 8 positive numbers up to plus 2 to the power of n minus 1 minus 1 and 8 negative numbers up to minus 2 to the power of n minus 1 minus 1. Here we can observe the two different representations of 0, plus 0 and minus 0. This creates a great deal of manipulation when performing arithmetic operations in digital circuit. Therefore, the use of sign magnitude form is somewhat impractical. Now, let's see the second form of signed binary number representation, that is 1's complement representation. In this 1's complement form, the representation is same if the MSB is 0, then it represents positive number. For example, if you want to represent plus 27 in 8-bit form, the magnitude of the number is represented in true binary form. Here, because of positive number, the MSB is equals to 0 and the rest of the bits represents its value. The representation of negative number in 1's complement form is somewhat different. For example, if you want to represent minus 27 in 8-bit form, we must invert the plus 27 binary bits. That means just invert zeros with 1's and 1's with zeros. And this inversion also includes the sign bit. These inverted bits represents minus 27 in 1's complement form. Here the MSB is 1. It denotes minus sign. So just by inverting 1's with zeros and zeros with 1's, we can find the 1's complement of a positive number. Let's see the mathematical representation of 1's complement form. For an n-bit binary number, the 1's complement is equal to 2 to the power of n minus 1 minus n. Let's see how it works. For example, if you want to represent decimal 27 in 8-bit form, then it is equals to 0001101. Now its 1's complement is equal to 2 to the power of 8 minus 1 minus 27. That equals to 256 minus 1 minus 27. That means 255 minus 27. So in binary form, we can represent these two numbers like this. So if we subtract these two binary numbers, then we get 1110100. That means the 1's complement of plus 27 is equals to 1110100. If we observe over here, whenever we are subtracting a binary number from all 1's, then zeros in that number will get replaced by 1, while 1's in that number gets replaced by zeros. So for n bits, the range of numbers that can be represented in the 1's complement form are minus 2 to the power of n minus 1 minus 1 to plus 2 to the power of n minus 1 minus 1. For example, using 4 bits, we can represent the numbers from minus 2 to the power of 4 minus 1 minus 1 to plus 2 to the power of 4 minus 1 minus 1. That is nothing but minus 7 to plus 7. Here in this table, 1's complement representation of all 4 bit binary numbers are listed. There are 8 positive numbers up to plus 2 to the power of n minus 1 minus 1 and 8 negative numbers up to minus 2 to the power of n minus 1 minus 1. Here you can see that similar to the sign magnitude form, there are two different representations of 0. This is the main disadvantage of the 1's complement form because it creates great deal of manipulation. That's all about 1's complement form. Now let's see the final one, that is 2's complement form of representation. In 2's complement form, the positive number representation is same as previous one. That means if the MSB or sign bit is 0, the number is positive. For example, if you want to represent plus 34 in 8-bit form, the magnitude of the number will be represented in true binary form. We can see that The MSP bit 0, which shows the number is positive. There are couple of ways to find the 2's complement form of this number. Let's see some of them. Now to represent minus 34 in 2's complement form, just observe the plus 34 bit. Starting from LSB, copy all bits until you encounter the first one, and then after, invert all zeros by 1's and all 1's by zeros including the sign bit. Here the MSB changed to 1. This shows it's a negative number. So after copying same bit starting from LSB up to first one and inverting all rest of the bits up to MSB, we can find the 2's complement form of minus 34. This is one way of finding 2's complement representation. Now let's discuss the second method. In this method, first take the 1's complement of the binary number plus 34. It is nothing but inverting all bits, zeros with 1's and 1's with zeros, and then add 1 to this 1's complement number. The resultant number which we got is the 2's complement of that particular number. Here this is minus 34 in 2's complement form. So by taking 1's complement then adding 1 to a particular binary number, we can obtain 2's complement representation of that number. This is the second method to find the 2's complement of a number. Now let's see the third method. It is by using mathematical formula. For a n bit number, its 2's complement is equals to 2 to the power of n minus n. So for example, if you want to represent the decimal number plus 34 in 8 bit binary form, it is 001000010. By using the above formula, 2's complement of this 8 bit number is 2 to the power of 8. Here n is 34. So 2 to the power of 8 minus 34. Here 2 to the power of 8 means 256. So 256 minus 34. Now represent both numbers in binary form. 256 in binary form is 100000000. Minus 34 in binary form is 001000010. Here if we does the binary subtraction, the resultant will be 110111110. This resultant number is the 2's complement of the number plus 34. Or in other way, it is the 2's complement representation of minus 34. So this is another way of finding 2's complement form. Now if we observe this 2's complement formula, 2 to the power of n minus n, it can be expanded as 2 to the power of n minus 1 minus n plus 1. If you observe this formula, this part of the formula 2 to the power of n minus 1 minus n is actually 1's complement of the number. Therefore, if we just take the 1's complement of a number and adding 1 to it will give you the 2's complement of that number. So these are the methods to find 2's complement of a number. Now using the n bits, the range of numbers which can be represented in 2's complement form are from minus 2 to the power of n minus 1 to plus 2 to the power of n minus 1 minus 1. For example, using 4 bits, we can represent the numbers from minus 2 to the power of 4 minus 1 to plus 2 to the power of 4 minus 1 minus 1. That is from minus 8 to plus 7. Here in this table, 2's complement representation of all 4 bit binary numbers are listed. We can represent positive numbers starting from 0 to plus 7. This positive bits range is mathematically given as plus 2 to the power of n minus 1 minus 1. On the other end, we can represent negative numbers starting from minus 1 to minus 8. Mathematically, negative bits range can be given as minus 2 to the power of n minus 1 minus 1. In 2's complement form, 0 is represented only once because its 2's complement is same in 4 bit representation. This is the biggest advantage of 2's complement form. Here, if we take the 2's complement of any positive number, then we will get negative number. For example, if we take the 2's complement of plus 4, we will get minus 4. Likewise, If we take 2's complement of negative number, we will get positive number. For example, the 2's complement of minus 3 is nothing but plus 3. But if we try to find the 2's complement of the most negative number, then we will get the same number. For example, here let's try to find out the 2's complement of the most negative number minus 8. To find 2's complement of 1000, we start from LSB and copy all the bits until we encounter the first one. So here the 2's complement of 1000 is same, that is 1000 only. The reason is that in 2's complement form, we can represent one more negative number than the positive number. So if we try to find 2's complement of most negative number, there is no corresponding positive number in the 4-bit representation. This is one more thing we must keep in mind while performing 2's complement. This 2's complement form is very useful in performing arithmetic operations in digital circuits, because we can use this without subtraction circuit. That's all about 1's complement and 2's complement representation of signed binary numbers. If you have learned from this video, please do mention them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe and turn on notifications for more such videos. Have a nice day.